my eyes into the hell. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth.
Well, welcome back, people. Hiking 121, back on the trail.
Surprise, surprise, he's not alone.
Surprise, surprise. Look who I got with me today. Old trooper.
Nobody else wants to go.
Nobody else wants to know? Nobody else wants to go, yeah, right. Everybody else had plans again. Everybody thinks they're too busy. Hey, you can see the shadow of my balloon
out there.
Anyway, here we are. We are at Mount Massive, just down the road from Mount Elbert. And ironically enough, we are in the Mount Massive wilderness. We are at the North Half Moon Trailhead. This route is about 7 miles round trip. That straight up, straight down.
Like that.
This is the short route. About 6 a.m.
We're late.
Let's hit the trails. Awesome to be here. Beautiful morning. We're expecting zero chance of precip today. Isn't that beautiful? Yeah. And it's October, people. We're hiking a 14er in October. This is very unusual.
It's not.
Well, we can hike 14ers in October, but usually you're doing it in the snow. Awesome, isn't that beautiful? I was wondering why that look on Josiah's face. Yeah, we're taking in the beauty this morning. We're taking in the beauty.
I thought it was beautiful.
It was a crisp 30 degrees this morning. And it is definitely the first weekend in October when you think the temperature, but this is kind of feel like we're living on borrowed time here for dry 14er hikes. So we're taking advantage of it. This is take two. I thought I took this video already, but I actually only took a picture. So now I gotta repeat everything I said just a little while ago. Look at that tree right there, all bent over. A lot of damage here. Must have been an avalanche or something through here. And there's Mount Elbert. We'll be seeing the sun here pretty quick, but I wanted to point out the trail goes right down there, and right where those people are standing, there's a sign: make a right and come up.
So and this
is where the elevation gain starts.
It's just in like Silverthorn or something, Trailhead or something.
It
like
said,
that.
Yeah, if you go straight at that sign, it's the Half Moon Trail, North Half Moon Trail, if you go straight. But make a right, go up the hill at that sign. There's a little, like someone carved in Mount Massive this way up there too.
They took a Sharpie and they drew Mount Massive.
Well, it was a Sharpie, I thought it was a carving. Anyway, okay. It's been generally pretty flat. It's been a slow elevation gain.
But now,
up until now,
it's gonna be fun.
It's gonna be real. Here we go. We've only gained 1,000 feet and we're about halfway through the hike. Proof that it's fall. Fall time in the Rocky Mountains. More fall colors.
Yeah,
There's this section here where you gotta follow the cairns. The little cairns. As you can see right over top of Josiah's head there. And there's one right there, center screen. Yep. Kind of a boulder field. It's a little tough to find the trail in some places.
Wait.
But.
I
just said this is a boulder field. This is not capital B boulder field, Long's Peak boulder field. That's a long ways from here. But anyway, you do walk through this boulder field. Just follow the cairns, you'll be fine. I have to point this out.
Wow.
Y'all, this is Albert. You remember from the Albert video? When we thought that bump in the middle of the screen, we thought that was the summit. Remember that false summit right there? Man, you look at Albert from this angle and you can hardly believe we thought that was the summit, but we did. It's a very majestic looking mountain from this angle. Very impressive. I'm gonna take a break, eat something, take in the beauty, take in the glory God has made, and just enjoying the morning. But it is steep. Up, up, up. That's what this trail does. It wears out little legs and big legs. But we're enjoying the day. It's beautiful out here. A little hazy. The fires are quite a ways from here. You can see some of the residual haze in the air from the fires. But mostly, it's clear.
Not as bad as Long's Peak.
Not near as bad as Long's Peak. No. Okay, so through here, you gotta follow the cairns. See here? Stacked up out there. Right by Josiah, standing by one there. Getting close to the first fall summit here. And it's easy to, we found it's easy to lose the trail on this, kinda. You just gotta look around. A little bit. Pay attention to where the trail goes. But you can get off the trail. Follow here. Almost to the ridge. We're over 14,000 feet. Well, 14,100 right now. There's La Plata in the middle. It's in the screen. There's our old friend. When Josiah sees a summit, I can't catch up with him. This kid.
I'm a monkey.
He's a monkey. He sees the summit and he's gone. I've been trying like crazy to catch up with him. I can't. So Zaya's gonna summit first. I'll be behind him. The wind here ain't too bad. I hope it's not too bad on top. Here comes 14er number 4 for Josiah. He's 10 years old. Fourth 14er. Absolutely incredible. Good job, buddy. You go do it, man. Go get it done. Woo! Yes.
Water.
Ladies and gentlemen, friends, relatives, distinguished guests, subscribers, non-subscribers, present to you, Josiah. And Bob, hiking 121, summit, Mount Massive, 14,422! Good grief, look at this. Got massive. We stinking got massive. We conquered massive. It is humbling. Grateful to the Lord. The Lord who gives strength, God who gives strength and ability and desire to do this. Welcome.
Thanks.
I think we're higher than Albert. See a pretty good distance. Wow. This one feels good. They all do. But this one, hard work. Southwest slopes, hard work. Soaking in the rays. We're gonna eat some beef jerky. A very nice man gave us beef jerky. Because we left our beef jerky at home by accident. And so we have plenty of water. We've got enough food. But a nice man on the way down said, "You guys doing good? You got enough food? Got enough supplies?" I said, "Yeah, we got enough food. Just a little disappointed. We forgot our beef jerky at home." And he whipped out a bag of beef jerky at us. Unbelievable. It was opened, it was about half full, but it is a lot of beef jerky, and there's very generous man, so that was very cool. Josiah, it's a champ. He saw the summit and ran. Wow, he didn't run, but he did. He ran. He cruised, so, yep. Pretty proud of him. Pretty proud of this guy. Four 14ers. Fourth 14er. Good job. I know, it's right there. I had no trouble going slow, believe me. All right, this has gotten long enough. Here's me and Josiah hanging out here, eating beef jerky. Cool. Ooh, can't have chewy sounds on video. So I'll tuck that away into my cheek. Yeah, we're hanging out here, eating our lunch, boiled eggs, beef jerky from the nice man in the mountain, banana, chips, and having a very, very chill time right here. Just chilling at 14,422 feet.
Time. My fourth time. Quite amazing.
Just chilling. I'm not sure if there's a better place on earth to be than to be at over 14,000 feet in the
Here's
Rocky
a fun
Mountains.
Idea. John Denver.
Rocky Mountain High. I'm sorry if I'm chewing. I shouldn't be chewing. It grosses people out when I chew.
It's just so good.
Yeah. Go get yourself some beef jerky right now and chew with me.
You'll know.
So, this is behind us. Let's go. Amazing.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. And like a flood, His mercy rains, unending love, amazing grace.
At the bottom, and hopefully I'll remember to video it. It was a memorial for an Army helicopter that crashed into Mount Massive in 2009. And it's a cross. It's a big wooden cross, and it's a nice memorial. But check this out: a piece of the helicopter just laying here by the trail, and no doubt a piece of the helicopter. So. Anyway, just a reminder of that. 4 men died in that crash. So, anyway. Just overwhelmed by God's majesty today. Just, these mountains are fantastic, just amazing. But yes, Josiah, you are an amazing hiker. There's a whole bunch of them. Yep. There's a younger one. There's 5 of them, my dear. Yep. Come quite a ways. The plot is no longer visible. We are now lower than everything.
We're not lower than the lake yet. That thing go air thing. It's in the wind thing. It's the wind thing on the lake.
Cool to see some mountain goats today. Taking a break. A well-deserved one.
More big to us.
What's interesting too, I should try to remember to get video of this when we're over there. But the tundra over here is kind of pretty. It's all red for fall. Yep. Here's that tundra I showed you earlier. We were just over there by that rock formation. So I'm over here now and it's kind of cool. This whole hillside, look at this, it's filled with it. You only see this in the fall. Even tundra changes colors in the fall. If you look real carefully at that hillside right there in front of you, you can see how it's all orange, kind of an orangish red. Same stuff. Tundra changing color. We're so happy to see this sign again.
I definitely give the hug.
Josiah hugged the sign. Now we're back to the easy part of the trail. Probably our last shot of Albert before we get into the trees. And I figure, since, you know, I was on Albert and all I could do was talk about Massive, figure, well, while I'm on Massive, I'll overdo it on Albert. It is impressive, though, to see this mountain from this angle. It's an impressive mountain. So, pretty neat. We're just about ready to get back in the trees, and we are ready for some shade. It is warm. So you remember earlier on in the video I showed you on top of the mountain there was some wreckage from a helicopter, and I told you that in 2009 that there was a crash on Mount Massive, an Army helicopter. There you go. Dedicated to the crew, Army Copter 26378, who lost their lives August 19, 2009, when the aircraft crashed on Mount Massive. Names of the guys. And
here's Mark. Here's
people put various paraphernalia here. Chad. And
that's Chad.
Yeah, there's Chad. There's one of the guys. And then people, I mean, yeah, there's pieces of wreckage that people find on the mountain, so they put it here. And it's a cross with American flags. And yeah, people bestowing all kinds of different kinds of gifts. So pretty interesting. So I thought I'd show you that. Mount Massive.
I did it.
He did it. Yep. Very excited about this one.
I did get teary-eyed at the ridge.
What was that?
I got teary-eyed at the ridge.
Yeah. This one affected Josiah a little bit. He got to the ridge there at the top. When he was blowing my doors, he pulled way ahead of me. That's on the video too. Anyway, he pulled way ahead. He said he got a little teary-eyed and emotional on top there. And that happens. That happens to me sometimes. We're gonna close this video out now. It was a great day. Thankful Josiah came along and we got to do this one. And planning another one for next week up in Indian Peaks again. So we're looking forward to that. So for the last time from Mount Massive, this is Hiking 121. Thanking you for watching. Please subscribe and share. And we will talk to you soon. Between the Mount Massive, the main Mount Massive trailhead, and the Southwest Slopes trailhead. The road between the main Massive trailhead and that is horrific. I'm in my Suburban, we're making it just fine, but it's exactly 3 miles from Mount Massive main trailhead to that Half Moon Trailhead where you start your, that where we did our hike today from. And I can only get 2.6 miles of the way. The last 2.4, or the last 0.4 miles, I didn't dare go anymore. It just got too bad. So anyway, so note, take a high clearance vehicle. As I pass this guy who doesn't have a high clearance vehicle, I don't know how he got in here. Sheer will, that's all I can say. All right, and awesome dispersed camping through here. Look up dispersed camping if you don't know what that is, but tons of it through here. So anyway, there you go.
My eyes into the help. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord.